He's not complying with the rules.
Right.
I know that.
And if he complied with it, we wouldn't be here.
58 years old, I've been through law enforcement.
Right. So we wouldn't be here. We're here to make sure that he complies.
He shows up.
He shows up.
Exactly.
Because we're also mandated that he shows up when he doesn't.
Yeah.
We're not here to beat him up. We're here to bring him where he needs to go, and then he can deal with it from there.
He has to make an appearance. We have to make an appearance.
Right.
He's not complying.
Tell him if he comes out, I will deal with him like a man and treat him like a man. I'll show him everything he wants to show.
Yeah.
He can do his writ when he gets where he needs to go. I don't have an issue with that. It's just if he wants to come to the window, I'll talk to him through the window. I have no issue with that. Can you tell him that? If he wants to come to this window, I'll talk to him. I'll explain everything to him. I get you. God bless you. I hope I make it 58 without issues.
Chris, will you come to the window and talk to me so I can explain everything?
I have asthma too, I get it.
That's worse than my asthma, man.
Yeah. That's fine with me too. just come talk to me at the window.
Okay, the court held you in contempt. I don't believe the district attorney's office did.
He held me in contempt.
That's between you and the court.
How long you know? You guys keep passing the buck, you know, but you want to come here with violence.
We're not coming here with violence.
What are you guys here to do? Kidnapping?
Chris, I told you you have a bench warrant. It's not kidnapping.
Well,
you have a bench warrant. You didn't show up in court.
Where is it? You knew you were coming here, right?
Yes, I have it, and I will give it to you. Come outside. You can film me all day. That's fine, Chris.
What's your name and badge number? And I want to see your valid state and your driver's license.
Okay, you're not getting a driver's license from me. I will show you my police ID. You're not going to see my driver's license. I have a driver's license. You want to see my police ID?
And your driver's license.
I'm not showing you my driver's license, Chris. I'll show you my police ID. What was that?
You want me to go in your car with you?
Correct.
I require to see a valid state and your driver's license.
Okay. I will show you whatever you want. Come outside. You want to see a driver's license? I'm going to put my finger over top of my address and everything.
Well, you know my address. Why are you here?
Because you have a bench warrant.
Man, you can't keep doing this to me, guys. You need to provide the paperwork to justify your previous actions. Further actions are not going to absolve you of what you have already done to me.
Chris.
I put in FOIA requests. Where's my information from the FOIA requests?
Chris, that's well above my head. I don't accept FOIA requests. I don't know who you even filed FOIA requests to.
I submitted papers concerning these matters.
Okay, to who? You didn't submit them to me.
To the Office of Professional Standards. And
PSD. Okay.
And the main office.
Okay.
So, you know.
Did they reply to your FOIA request?
They sent me something in the mail. I got responses from the FOIA request. They need more time for that. So, obviously, they can correspond with me through the mail. So, not these surprise warrants, and you guys are going to try and kidnap me again. I was in jail for 18 fucking days.
Chris,
you guys kicked my door in. You can't do that.
Chris, you have a bench warrant. That's what I'm explaining to you.
Well, then, just why don't you, I'll get a court date and serve me with the paper because that's the duty of the sheriff's office.
I need to
remind you, that's the duty of the sheriff's office to serve papers.
Okay, it's not to serve you. It's not to serve you. Your
should
court
always
date.
Be preference to a warrant.
Chris, that's not how that works. You know.
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
No.
A
summons is prior to your trial, or your bench trial, or appearing in court. That's what a summons is prior to. Once you appear in court, it turns into a bench warrant. You should know this. Read it correctly. If you're going to read the law, read it correctly.
Where
summonses are prior to you appearing in court, not after you appear in court, Chris. I know the law just as well as you do. Make sure you read it correctly when you do it. The summons is prior to you appearing in court.
Okay,
after you appear in court, it's considered a bench warrant.
Summons?
You were summoned. You've appeared in court, Chris. You've appeared in court multiple times. And now, all of a sudden, you don't want to appear in court. That's
all, and it wasn't me.
Okay, well, you have a bench warrant.
I'm in court. All you need to do is summons me to court. Now, you come here and kidnap me.
Chris,
the paperwork.
The summonses don't go anymore. You're failing to appear in court. That's why you were summoned at the beginning of this. There is no more summonses, Chris. Chris, there's no more summonses. You failed to appear in court on your court date. On your court dates.
When are you alleging that I failed to appear?
That's between you and the court. They issued a warrant, a bench warrant for your arrest. That's why we were here.
You guys said the last time and you kicked my door in and there's been no paperwork.
Chris, here. This is how we're going to end it. Okay?
That's all I gotta do.
That's not how bench warrants work, Chris. With a bench warrant, we are mandated to bring you in front of the judge. Correct? You know the law. We are mandated to bring you in front of the judge for a bench warrant. Correct, Chris? Am I correct or no? Am I correct or no, Chris?
Where are these warrants?
I will give you the warrant.
I have not seen any of them. I've seen fraudulent ones.
Okay, I don't have to show you it right here, Chris. You know that.
None of them, they're never produced. You guys always say
Chris,
that.
I have it in my car. You know I don't have to show you directly here.
Yes,
you know
please.
I have... That is a lie, Chris. Read the law correctly. Read the law correctly, Chris. If we're going to play games, read it correctly. I have to provide it to you at some point. All I have to do is advise you that I have the warrant, and then I have to provide it to you upon arrest. Upon arrest, Chris, read it correctly. If you're going to... I'm correcting you, Chris, because you're mitigated and taking whatever part of the law you want to proceed. Chris, that's not how it works.
Yes, it is.
A summons is prior to you not showing up in court.
I do not have a court date.
Chris, you do, and you failed to show up on that court date.
When?
You know when it was, Chris.
No, I don't.
Chris.
No, I don't.
All right, so this is how we're going to finish it, Chris. You have a bench warrant, okay? And until that bench warrant is satisfied, we are going to come and knock on your door every day, requesting that you come with us to set... on the bench warrant, which is put you in front of the judge for your bench warrant, Chris. You know that.
No, I don't know that.
Okay.
Okay.
So when are you gonna show up in court, Chris?
Whenever I'm needed there. Whenever I'm properly summoned there and serving papers.
I'll
contact the court again. I contacted the court and I made a record of it that I asked for a court date because I was let out of the holding center with no court date.
Which time? When you got the contempt charge for $1?
No. I guess you don't know what happened. You don't know the whole story.
I know there's multiple times you've been to the holding center, Chris.
My fucking door in.
Right, for a warrant.
From your office.
For a warrant.
Claim to have a warrant. Where is that warrant?
You should have been arraigned on it, Chris. Because it was taken out of the system after you were taken into custody, so you should have been arraigned on it. Correct? You want to use your logic and your false logic and your
law. The law is expressed, not implied.
Chris, you're making false laws and you're taking bits and pieces of the law that you want to use. You're not using the full law.
Chris, I had a court date.
Chris,
if there was
you were given a court date and you failed to appear, Chris.
When? You can't just claim that.
Chris, you failed to appear. You know you failed to appear.
No, I don't know that.
Okay. Chris, you have a bench warrant.
Try resolving these matters.
Chris, let me finish. We're going to continue to come here to finish our obligation of the bench warrant until you are brought in front of a judge. Whether you do it on your own or with us.
I'm telling you. You can't say you're acting in good faith.
We are acting in good faith because I'm here trying to peacefully resolve this and satisfy our obligation to bring you in front of the judge.
Trying to kidnap me? That's not.
We're not trying to kidnap you, Chris. You have a bench warrant. That's not kidnapping, Chris. So
you don't have a warrant.
We do have a warrant.
You would have to have a warrant.
Okay.
If you're here to apprehend me, you have to have a warrant, not me.
Chris, again, you want to use you want to use bits and pieces of the law to fit your problem.
I want resolution in these matters.
Okay. Get resolution then, Chris. Show up in court.
Okay. I need a court date. I've been trying to get one, and I made a record of that. I'm telling you now, and I published it, so it's known. I diligently tried to contact everyone I could possibly think of,
Chris,
to get a court date, to seek resolution of these matters.
Unfortunately, you want to bend and twist the law to fit your narrative, Chris, No, we're not, because I've satisfied my obligation by explaining to you everything, and you don't want to listen. So you have a bench warrant. We're going to continue to come here until that bench warrant is satisfied. And if you don't like it, follow up with the court. Follow up with the court, Chris.
Right?
Chris, follow up with the court.
If
you want us to stop coming here to satisfy our obligation to bring you in front of a judge, call the court, Chris. We'll be back. Until you satisfy the obligation, Chris, we will be back. Because we have to satisfy.
What do you want me to do? You want me to contact the court to get a court date?
Correct, Chris.
Okay. Don't threaten me.
I'm not threatening you. I'm telling you what's going to happen.
Don't come back. There's no trespassing sign right there.
Okay, you have a bench warrant, and I'm not trespassing. The law states that we can come to your front door, which is right here. And instead of coming to your front door, you decided to talk to me through a window. I am not trespassing, Chris. Chris, read the Supreme Court rulings the right way, Chris. We're not, Chris. Read the Supreme Court rulings the right way, Chris.